WWF, what the world is watching.
Turn it on and rip the knob off.
Hey guys, and welcome back to the Wrestling Memory Grenade, now at episode 141. Are you guys ready to have some more fun? I am your host, Ray Russell, bringing you the very first 2 weeks of August 1988 WWF TV, right here this week, as we grow ever so close to the inaugural SummerSlam. Not too far away, guys. Let's see what they do here to help continue the build. As we won't waste any time, going to jump right back into things here this week. Actually, first, before we do that, got to give a shout out there to one of the loyal listeners, maybe the loyalist of listeners, a true supporter of the Grenade, a true supporter of the WrestleCopia brand. Want to thank Matt Crowder for everything he's done here as a supporter, a true wrestling memory grenadier. And with that out of the way, guys, now it's time to jump back into August of 1988 in the World Wrestling Federation, getting ever so close to SummerSlam. And it all kicks off this week with the August 6th edition of the WWF's Superstars of Wrestling. And away we go, guys. Superstars for August 6th. Tape all the way back July 13th in La Crosse, Wisconsin. The La Crosse Center. Vince McMahon and Jesse the referee. That's Mega Ref. Ventura on commentary this week as we go off to the ring to see The Rock, Don Muraco, take on Dave Wagner, going to kick it off. We get an insert promo out of the gate from Greg Valentine, who calls Muraco stubborn. Stubborn as a rock, he says, but the hammer vows he will make The Rock submit to the figure four before too long. In the ring here, Muraco versus Wagner, it's a power slam, knee lift, and a catapult, sending Wagner into the corner. Don Muraco then climbing to the top rope, gonna ride his knee down into the face of Wagner. Little inverted riding knee drop, a la Dick Murdoch or Ivan Koloff. In the meantime, Don Muraco, tombstone pile driver, gonna pick up the win 2 minutes and 30 seconds. So they're still promoting the Muraco-Valentine feud here, while also promoting Muraco versus Bravo at SummerSlam. Really no reason or rhyme to that match, but I guess you could call it Dino's Revenge for WrestleMania 4. But who even remembers that? Better question, who would want to remember that? But it is The Rock taking on the Canadian Strongman at SummerSlam. As we roll off up next to update with Mean Gene Okerlund, the returning Mean Gene. We saw him back here last Grenade. And Okerlund going to recap the recent feud between the Mega Powers and the Mega Bucks. The match will go down as the main event at the big pay-per-view SummerSlam with Mega Ref Jesse Ventura acting as that special referee. And with the body on commentary here all throughout Superstars, you better believe we hear a whole lot about that match, Jesse's integrity, and everything in between. And speaking of said match, we go back to the ring singles action. Going to see the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, accompanied to the ring by bodyguard Virgil, Bobby Heenan, and Andre the Giant. DiBiase's opponent this week, Mike Richards. And per the usual, Richards, the job guy, going to get the best of DiBiase to begin things, get a little heat on Teddy here. Nice arm drag by Richards, which only seems to piss Teddy off as he takes over and grinds away on Mike Richards from there. Falling fist drop, textbook suplex, standing elbow from DiBiase off the middle rope. And as I just mentioned moments ago, with DiBiase in the ring and Jesse on commentary, Vince McMahon has to ask the question. Put the Mega Ref Ventura on the spot. Ask him if he's been bought off by the Million Dollar Man. I mean, what's he going to say, Vince?
Yeah.
Of course, Ventura denying those allegations as we go back to the action. DiBiase landing his patented power slam, followed by the million-dollar dream. Going to get the quick win. 1 minute and 50 seconds. $100 bill stuffed down Richard's throat for his troubles there. But the action continues on as we go off back to the ring. Bret the Hitman Hart, Jim the Anvil Neidhart, Hart Foundation back together again, taking on the team of Tom Stone and Chris Curtis. As we get an insert promo from the still legal manager of the Hart Foundation, Jimmy Hart, vowing the Harts will never be the tag team champions again, and that all starts at SummerSlam. Hart stating that the Hart Foundation only champions because Jimmy was in their corner, baby. As the action continues here into the matchup, the Anvil puts a forearm through the chest of poor Chris Curtis, followed by a power slam, but Neidhart gonna pull Curtis up on the two count. Poor Chris Curtis just dismantled for several minutes by both Hart Foundation. Lots of quick tags and the Hart attack, putting Curtis away 3 minutes and 19 seconds. Hart Foundation looking ready for their tag team title match at the pay-per-view. As we head back to the ring, the action just keeps rolling on. Terry Taylor taking on Chris Todd, and this will mark Terry's syndicated debut. So he has officially now made it here to the World Wrestling Federation. Now, we already saw him, though, turn heel in his actual debut, teaming with Sam Houston in a loss to the Conquistadors. Can't really blame Taylor for that one. Houston doing a job to the masked Conquistadors on a recent primetime wrestling, and Terry Taylor letting him have it. Terry will continue to play the heel here, strutting between moves. Kind of strutting like a rooster, I guess you could say. I guess you could call him the cock of the walk, if you will. Maybe this is where they got the idea for the name. Watching Terry Taylor strut around, it wasn't your Jackie Fargo, Buddy Rogers, Ric Flair type of strut here. No, no, this was very much reminiscent of an actual rooster. I kind of see where they got the idea. Not making excuses, though. Don't misquote me. As during the matchup, we actually get an insert promo from Taylor as he refers to himself as Scary Terry Taylor. Not so sure that isn't worse than the Red Rooster. Scary Terry talking about how handsome he is. As in the ring, Taylor going to land a rough-looking spine buster, and he's going to lock in the Scorpion Deathlock, referred to as the Scorpion here in the WWF at this point in time anyway. Going to get the submission win, 2 minutes and 21 seconds in a very uneventful, no pomp, no circumstance, no big entrance. Not even a mention of his debut in the intro hype this week. Just randomly out there, Terry Taylor picking up a win, and in that same robe that he'd wear forever, guys, you know the one, gifted to Bobby Roode much later on. Yes, that one in the very same, but Terry Taylor now here in the World Wrestling Federation, gonna have to wait and see what happens with them next. As we roll off now to our very first event center this week, Sean Mooney standing by as we hear from the Mega Powers.
The Mega Powers versus the Mega Bucks. The Macho Man, Randy Savage, and Hulk Hogan facing the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, and Andre the Giant. That's the main event of SummerSlam 88. Jesse the Body Ventura will be the special guest referee. And right now, the Mega Powers have these comments.
Yo, Mega Power people!
Yeah!
We got one heck of a reputation to live up to, Macho Brother. We have turned ourselves into the ultimate human destruction machine because the task at hand needs that, brother. We have to be sharp. We have to be keen. We have to be ready, brother.
I'm gonna be ready, yeah!
You better believe it, brother. But the big nasty giant, Andre the Giant, who's been throwing his 560 pounds around for so long around the WWF, that is gonna be the one we get first. The first priority is to chop down the giant.
One thing, too, let's not forget the multi-million-dollar man. His dirty money,
yeah. Set people up. Whoa, oh, man.
Wow.
Macho brother.
Ooh,
how about one for the holster, dude?
You want me to kiss you?
No, not you.
Wow, manager of the Mega Powers. Everything's okay. Trust you right there, loser.
Oh, man, you know what something?
Happened? Yeah.
You know something, Mega Bucks? One kiss is going to make us free, and it's going to make you weak, man. Never before have I been in such a situation that all my Hulkamaniacs have put so much trust in my partner. I'm not afraid of nothing. I fear no man or giant. And all I got to say, when the act is finished with Miss Elizabeth on the ringside, brother, if something happened, the giant clubs us down. If the multi-million dollar man pays off, Jesse the Body Ventura.
We're what?
All you gotta do, man.
Yeah.
Is look through the sweat. Look at the reason we're fighting, brother.
Elizabeth!
That's right, man. There's no way they're gonna beat the mega powers.
SUMMERSLAM! Yeah!
SUMMERSLAM! Yeah!
So you guys, if you were listening really closely, maybe you heard something there, but you couldn't see it, so I'm going to break it down for you. At one point in this promo, Miss Elizabeth gives Randy Savage a smooch on the cheek, and it's at that time that Hulk Hogan has the fucking nerve to ask for one as well. Hey, you got one, brother. She's my manager too, dude. No wonder Macho Man turns on him.
Lust in the eyes,
From the very beginning, Randy. From the very beginning. So the Mega Powers do indeed sound ready, however, to take on the Mega Bucks at the big pay-per-view as we roll back to the ring for Tito Santana,
Arriba,
in action against Tim Dixon, and this match solely used as a backdrop for Jesse and Vince to talk about the big pay-per-view, SummerSlam, of course. Now, Jesse does also slide in a little comment here about Rick Martel. The Body says that Martel, he should have been healed by now and is simply afraid to return due to demolition. As this is another classic Tito squash, which means a whole lot of arm work. But the flying forearm going to put Dixon away. Tito scores the win, 3 minutes and 58 seconds. As we roll off now to a special interview up on the stage, Craig DeGeorge standing by with the greatest intercontinental champion of all time, the Honky Tonk Man, and his manager, Colonel Jimmy Hart.
August 29th, circled on your calendar, Madison Square Garden, the SummerSlam. Brutus the Barber Beefcake, his final chance to wrest away the Intercontinental Championship, taking on you, Honky Tonk Man, for that crown.
His final chance. It's the final meeting of Brutus the Barber Beefcake and the greatest Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion of all time, the Honky Tonk Man.
Huh.
Yeah. When I took one look at the contract, and it said the final meeting for SummerSlam on August the 29th at my favorite place, Madison Square Garden.
They love
it. There's nothing more that I wanted to do than sign a dotted line.
Let me bring up one point here, Honky Tonk Man. Jimmy Hart, you listen in too. The Barber Brutus Beefcake has stated he will do at least one of the two following things. Either he will leave the ring at Madison Square Garden with that belt around his waist, or you will leave the ring at Madison Square Garden with a new haircut. One or two, maybe both.
He's going to do one of the two. Take my belt or cut my hair. I've said it before and I'll say it again. I am the greatest Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion of all time. Nobody's taking my belt and nobody's cutting my hair. The final meeting, Brutus the Barber, because if you can't beat me then, you will never, ever get another chance for the Honky Tonk Man. I'm going to do one thing in Madison Square Garden. I'm going to sing my song loud and clear. Thank you very much.
All right, Honky Tonk, we'll find
Honky
out.
Honky Tonk is going to sing. I think the pressure's on Beefcake, McMahon. We'll be back with more World Wrestling Federation action.
Well, there you hear it. They put over the upcoming title match, the IC title on the line, against Brutus the Barber Beefcake at SummerSlam, as this will be Brutus's final chance at the gold. But Honky, he doesn't sound too concerned out there about losing the belt or his hair. He says he's got all his fans behind him, all the beautiful people, waiting to see him retain the title and sing for the masses at MSG. So not a whole lot to this promo. Not much left to do after feuding for 6 months between these two. The wheels are kind of just spinning in place, waiting for this match to happen, as Honky and Beefer slated to have their final dance at this point in time at the pay-per-view. And it's back to the ring for tag team action. Going to see Nikolai Volkov, Boris Zukov, the Bolsheviks, with manager Slick in their corner, taking on the team of Warren Bianchi and JT Thomas. As we hear the Russian national anthem sang by Nikolai before the matchup, we also get an insert promo here from the Powers of Pain, who have the Bolsheviks at SummerSlam, and everywhere else to be exact. The Barbarian says, "Welcome to the Wild Kingdom, Bolsheviks." The Russians in for some trouble there when they get to the pay-per-view. Meanwhile, Vince McMahon on commentary here invites us to look at the cranium of Boris Zukov as the Russians will dominate JT Thomas and then Bianchi. Volkov with an over-the-shoulder backbreaker as Zhukov gonna forearm him, looks like shit, then the Russian sickle from Boris, followed by, once again, Nikolai with the over-the-shoulder backbreaker, and again, Zhukov with another forearm across the chest of his opponent, but this time off the middle rope. Nikolai may have screwed up that first time around. They do it this time, and the Bolsheviks gonna score the win over Bianchi. Whatever. At least it's over. Match goes 2 minutes and 18 seconds. The Bolsheviks scoring the win. One more match here this week on Superstar sees Jake the Snake Roberts take on Harley Manson. And Jake is over as hell here with the crowd. Classic DDT finisher. Going to get the quick win. 1 minute and 55 seconds. And wouldn't you know it, Damien Fun going to follow there on poor Harley Manson. And really, when you think about it, next to the main event right now, Mega Powers feuding with Dibiase, Andre the Giant, the biggest feud in the WWF has to be Jake Roberts versus Rick Rude. And yet somehow, they're both working mid-card matches at the pay-per-view. Total bummer in the booking. As we roll off now to the following day and the August 7th edition of the WWF's Wrestling Challenge. All right, it is challenged for August the 7th, tape back July 14th, Cedar Rapids, Iowa at the Five Seasons Center. Of course, Gorilla Monsoon, Bobby Heenan on commentary for this one. Off to the ring for tag team action. Going to see the Powers of Pain take on George Petraski and Rick Renslow as we get an insert promo here from Slick and his Bolsheviks hyping their pay-per-view match at the SummerSlams. Got to love how everybody announces SummerSlam from Hitman's In the SummerSlam to Slickster's Summer Slams. It's a very interesting throwback to see how little people did to learn the name of the pay-per-view. As nevertheless, it is the Bolsheviks taking on the Powers of Pain, and the Powers of Pain hailing from parts unknown. You could actually argue parts unknown could easily be in parts of Russia. As this matchup, a warm-up of sorts for the Powers of Pain, as the future Russian brute, George Petraski and Renslow here, try to attack the POP, but fail miserably. Renslow going to get eaten up first, and then it's Petraski's turn in the ring as the Warlord lands the running power slam and the Barbarian diving headbutt. Going to get the win here for the babyface duo. Match goes 1 minute and 49 seconds as we roll off now to a special report with Craig DeGeorge. At the top of the report, we get a replay of the Mega Powers Mega Bucks build, leading to this, a SummerSlam report.
Hello, everyone. I'm Craig DeGeorge. Welcome to this week's special report. You know, there are so many happenings, issues going on here in the World Wrestling Federation that quite often it becomes an arduous task to select our focus each week here in the special report. But I'm happy to say it took us exactly one half of a second to figure out our topic this week. Of course, it is SummerSlam 88, and the fireworks are set for Monday, August the 29th, 8 p.m., Madison Square Garden in New York City. Now, if you can't see the matches in person, no problem, because this can't-miss extravaganza will be available on pay-per-view systems nationwide. Let's get to the nuts and bolts of SummerSlam 88. I'm sure you're still digesting the big news. The long-awaited announcement came last week. Randy Macho Man Savage, the undisputed World Wrestling Federation champion, naming Hulk Hogan, joining the Macho Man against Ted DiBiase, the Million Dollar Man, and the eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant. The Mega Powers against the Mega Bucks. And the guest referee will be Jesse the Body Ventura, who, by the way, is calling himself the Mega Ref. Gonna be something else. Also on the card, SummerSlam 88, Coco Beware against the Big Boss Man. The Slickster will also have his Bolsheviks taking on the alarming new tag team, the Powers of Pain. The tag team title on the line. Demolition defending its crown against the former champs, the Hart Foundation. Also, the British Bulldogs will battle the Rougeau brothers. Hercules grapples with Jake the Snake Roberts. The Rock, Don Muraco, and Dino Bravo will collide. And how about this one? Honky Tonk Man and Brutus the Barber Beefcake, you know they've met a few times before, but they will never meet again after SummerSlam 88. Honky Tonk's coveted intercontinental title at stake. The Barber says at least one of two things will happen. Either Beefer will leave the ring as champion, or Honky Tonk will exit with a new haircut. If all goes well, both happenings could indeed occur. Junkyard Dog against Ravishing Rick Rude. Ken Patera, Bad News Brown. That rounds out the card. And oh, by the way, how about this? First live appearance for Brother Love, who, word has it, will have a very, very special guest with him. SummerSlam 88, Madison Square Garden, on pay-per-view around the country, Monday, August the 29th at 8 p.m. Intercontinental title, tag team title, Mega Bucks, Mega Powers, highlighting this great card. And indeed, we'll have more on SummerSlam 88 in the coming weeks. With the special report, I'm Craig DeGeorge.
All right, there it is. All 10 matches announced for the show. And if that wasn't enough, Brother Love, any special guest? Who will it be? You guys will have to wait to find out as we roll back to the ring for Ravishing Rick Rude in action. Bobby Heenan by his side. Rude taking on Billy Brown. As pre-match, we get Rude's usual stick on the mic, referring to the Iowa sharecroppers. Well, now he's stealing Bad News' gimmick. But Rude going to take off his robe to reveal, is that Cheryl Roberts' face on the crotch and the ass of Rick Rude's tights?
Holy shit, dude.
Wow, that's something else for the times, as we get an insert promo from Rude telling Jake to get a pair of the WWF binoculars to see just how ravishing he is and maybe get a better look at those trunks. Hey, Rick, I mean, that could be taken two ways, really. You need binoculars to see what you got going on down there? But really, just a way to sell the WWF binoculars, which, if you haven't seen the pictures yet, looks like somebody shoved some, hopefully, mini binoculars into an animal cracker box, and that's what you get. But this one, quick matchup, butt flex pose with Cheryl's face on his ass. Gotta love Rick Rude. It is the Rude Awakening, scoring the quick win, 1 minute and 15 seconds, and then post-match, an awakening of another kind. A kiss to maybe the prettiest girl yet, pulled from the crowd. But man, how the fuck are you going to work an angle like this and not put the match on pay-per-view? Rick Rude has Jake's wife's face, her likeness, if you will, on the front and back of his tights. I guess they just wanted to stretch it out on the house shows for as long as they could. But still, even a screwjob finish at SummerSlam just gives you some more heat. Would have been suffice for me. It is what it is, as we roll on back to Sean Mooney in the Event Center. We're going to hear from the tag teams involved in the upcoming tag team title match at the pay-per-view. It's, of course, the champions Demolition alongside Mr. Fuji and Jimmy Hart. Okay. We're also going to hear from the challengers, the Hart Foundation.
As part of this incredible card, tag team champions Demolition will defend their titles against the Hart Foundation. We have comments from both champions and challengers.
In SummerSlam 88, I will join forces with Mr. Fuji and the Demolition, and I will tell all I know about all the Hart Foundation's weaknesses.
Oh, very good, Jimmy Hart. Yes. You sing like birds, you give Master Fuji all information. Yes. I will tell Demolition exactly what you told me.
Just like Mr. Fuji says, when you step through those ropes, you put your head right through that between the top and the second rope, and kaboom! We're gonna kick your teeth in!
You don't go into the biggest match of your career without the guiding light, the anvil, and the hitman. SummerSlam, we own Madison Square Garden. We're gonna own you. We're gonna see how tough the anvil is, and we're gonna teach the hitman what hitting's about.
The final countdown, Jim, the Demolitions. I like to think of this one as Bozo the Clown and the Tin Man, managed by Charlie Chan. But there's also gonna be Jimmy Hart in the background. Big deal. We're not going to make too much of that because, Jimmy Hart, you can tell all you know about the Hart Foundation, and you'll be able to tell in all but 3 seconds. This is the Hart Foundation, the new rebuilt Hart Foundation, and we are back and better than ever.
Isn't that interesting, Hitman, what the Demolition had pulled out of the trash bin, Jimmy Hart? Boy, Jimmy Hart's got a lot of good ideas he's going to interject in the Demolition. You're on the right track, Demolition. You just keep going, Jimmy Hart.
We never, ever needed you, ever.
What a battle that is going to be. Just one of the four tag team matches taking place at SummerSlam 88.
So it appears Demolition and Fuji have brought in Jimmy Hart to serve as an informant of sorts, giving the champions all the info they need to know about the challenger Hart Foundation. And though it doesn't sound like the Hart Foundation too concerned about regaining the gold, they think they got this one in the bag. In the SummerSlam It's all going to go down in just 3 weeks' time, guys. Right now, though, back to the ring for Brutus the Barber Beefcake. Going to take on Warren Bianchi. As we get an insert promo from Honky Tonk and Jimmy Hart in this one, Honky upset that the Barber is on the cover of the latest edition of the WWF magazine. Why not the IC champ? As some strutting going to begin the matchup, eating up about 30 seconds of action. Finally, Beefer going to take control and score the win with the sleeper hold. Match goes 2 minutes and 2 seconds, and Bianchi got to get one of those summer trims to follow. And then it's right back to the event center. More Sean Mooney. And on Superstars, we heard from the Mega Powers, so it's only fair now that we hear from the other side. It's the Mega Bucks.
Well, earlier on, you saw the Mega Powers, the Macho Man, Randy Savage, and Hulk Hogan. And of course, on Monday night, August 29th, they will meet the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, and Andre the Giant in the main event of SummerSlam 88. The Mega Bucks combination is now standing by, along with manager Bobby the Brain Heenan and bodyguard Virgil. And their comments are most interesting, to say the least.
Welcome back, ex-champ. You're coming back, and you're more than welcome. But it looks like you're not too sure of yourself anymore, Hogan. Huh? You have to take that little monkey with you now? But Hogan, come in that ring to that SummerSlam. I'll show you again what it is to be the only wrestler in the world to be undefeated. Because I put you down before a few times, and I will put you down again. And you, little champ, it's chimpanzee.
Chimpanzee. Yeah. That's right, Hogan. How many times are you going to go to the well before you realize that you can't beat this man? You know, Bobby, they're calling this the Mega Powers versus the Mega Bucks. We've got all that on one team because there's nothing more powerful in the world than the eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant. And the power of the money of the Million Dollar Man just keeps rolling on and on and on. Look through history. Look through history, and it proves itself time and time again. The people with power are the people with money. And mine keeps talking, right, Bobby?
That's right. We don't only have the Mega Powers, the Mega Bucks. We got the Mega Brains. And we even got a good referee.
Special guest referee Jesse the Body Ventura has said there will be a decisive victor in this tag team meeting in SummerSlam 88. Here's more on how you can see it.
So Andre the Giant says Hulk Hogan was scared, so he went and got that little monkey, Randy Savage, as his partner. Okay. They always said Andre was not a fan of Randy in the ring.
The baby oil, boss.
Of course, the heel pair here mentioning having a good, honest referee in Jesse Ventura. And then having some laughs at the thought. The plot thickens as they continue to insinuate that Jesse Ventura has been bought off. As we go back to the ring for the Iron Sheik, you heard me right, Sheik still here with Slick in his corner on Wrestling Challenge. Sheik's opponent here, Tim, not Kim Yates, as reported online. This is Tim Yates, as we even get an insert promo from the Iron Sheik. USA Haktua. I guess you could call him the talk tour here. As Sheik comes to the ring with the Iranian flag, some cheap iron-on letters on both sides of the flag that read Iran. Iron-on Iran, I guess. And Sheiky Baby gonna attack Yates, tosses his robe over Yates' face, and Heenan shouts out, "Look, it's another Arab!" Again, I say,
"Holy shit, dude."
Gorilla pointing out that Sheik has gained at least 40 pounds since the last time he was here, i.e., he got fat. Sheiky Baby gonna do the old straddle over the middle rope, boss man style, and then a nice back suplex, laying Yates out for the Kamar Clutch. Gonna get the win in 1 minute and 46 seconds. So Sheik factored back into the fold, back on TV. Slick once again acting as his manager, and they're starting to run a feud between Sheik and Patera on the house shows in the early part of August, just in time for the 88 Summer Olympics. Unfortunately, the day this aired, August 7th, was also the final day that Sheik would be working the house shows. He was fired right around this time, and we won't see him again here in the WWF for another 3 years. Colonel Mustafa, the next time the Iron Sheik appears here in the World Wrestling Federation, as this match marks the final appearance in 1988 of the Iron Sheik. Mother the fuck. Sorry, Sheik, as we go off now to the Brother Love Show. Initially announced as the special guest, the Million Dollar Man Ted DiBiase. But Brother Love has a surprise coming.
The one and the only, my dear close personal friend, the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, be my guest here this week. Welcome, Matt.
It's the wrong music.
Oh, that's the right music. DiBiase
doesn't have any music.
No, but the Macho Man does, and here he comes. He's not supposed to be there. He won't get any C notes slipped into his pocket this week.
Of love is completely different, yeah, because your benefactor is the multi-million dollar man Ted DiBiase, yeah, and the macho
look at him, he don't know what to do.
Definition of love, yeah, is the love for the manager of the mega powers, Elizabeth, yeah. Stand back, it'll be better for your health in the long run, brother.
Or Savage is a bully.
And I also love being the World Wrestling Federation champion. But there's one more person that he is a definition of the word love. Yeah. And he's my partner in the SummerSlam. And I'm talking about Hulk Hogan.
Something in his pants again this week, but it won't be green.
What is your definition of the word love?
Brother Love, don't go nowhere, man. I got a whole different definition. Number one, I love being a Hulkster, man, and I love all my little Hulkamaniacs. Right now, I love the fact that I'm gonna get my hands on you.
Oh, there he goes.
Ooh, yeah. Hogan's in love, yeah! You know, Macho Man, you and I get something in common when it comes to love, man. What's that, Hulkster?
You and I both love the fact that in the SummerSlam, we're gonna be able to chop that nasty, flea-infested giant down to size.
Ooh, yeah!
We also love the fact that we're gonna be able to put this knuckle sandwich right between the multi-million dollar man's cash register time after time.
Right again!
And something else that we both love is the fact that at the end of the SummerSlam, right in the middle of Madison Square Garden, you and I, as the Mega Powers, are gonna be standing right in the center of the ring with our arms raised in victory.
Mm, yeah, and one other thing, not only do I want you to take the eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant, and hold him over your head, give him the big, big body slam, but right now, let's show each and every one of these mega power maniacs where Elizabeth is gonna be at the end of the SummerSlam.
Oh, look at this. Elizabeth going for a ride up on his shoulders of the Macho Man. As he and the Hulkster, the Mega Powers, will be doing their thing Monday, August 29th, SummerSlam 88 in Madison Square Garden. What a couple.
You know something, Monsoon, it takes...
So, this week's guest originally announced to be the benefactor of the Brother Love Show, talking about the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, but instead, Brother interrupted by the undisputed WWF champion, Macho Man Randy Savage, and the lovely Miss Elizabeth. As the Macho Man loves something too. He loves being the WWF champion. He also loves his new tag team partner, as out comes Hulk Hogan, who loves no one. He just lusts, brother. Anywho, the Mega Powers running off, Brother Love, as Hulk threatens the poor guy. Hulk Hogan, always a bully. You know, when all your friends turn on you, maybe they're not the problem, brother. I'd keep a close eye on him, Randy. As Hulk and Mach then talk more about Love. For instance, they're going to love beating the Megabucks at SummerSlam. Hulk Hogan would also love to raise Miss Elizabeth on his shoulder along with the Macho Man. Of course you would, dude. The duo then lifting Miss Liz high onto their shoulders as they walk back to the locker room to close the segment here. So, Brother Love Show, hostile takeover by the Mega Powers as they say their piece here on Challenge as well, leading into the big pay-per-view, back to the ring tag team action. The Rockers taking on Dave Wagner and Tom Burton. Marty Jannetty, Shawn Michaels out here with an interesting spot as Burton tries to leapfrog Marty, but as he does, he lands straight into a belly-to-belly from Shawn Michaels. That was pretty clever. Double spinning back elbow onto Renslow from the Rockers, and Michaels with a flying fist drop from Jannetty's shoulders down onto Wagner as referee Jack Kruger makes the very loud 1, 2, 3. The Rockers go over 3 minutes and 1 second as the action just keeps going. Hacksaw Duggan out next to take on Pete Sanchez. And not a whole lot to this one, guys. Normal Hacksaw shenanigans out here. And the 3-point stance and clothesline. Boy, did he go flying through. Pete Sanchez going to give Duggan the win. 2 minutes and 7 seconds. As we close out this edition of Wrestling Challenge, we roll off to Primetime Wrestling for August the 8th, 1988.
I'm Gorilla Monsoon.
And I'm your host of Host, Bobby the Brain Heenan.
Hello, everyone, and welcome once again to Primetime Wrestling, where, as always, we feature the superstars of the World Wrestling Federation, and it's 3 weeks and counting. 3 weeks till Monday night.
Do you think Hogan and Savage are talking to each other? Maybe they made a big mistake, even messing with the Megabucks?
Well, they're talking
Megabucks
to each other. You can count on that, and they didn't make any kind of mistake.
Well, when we're done,
you're
we're
the ones that made the mistake.
They're going to be talking to themselves when we're finished with them.
Well, as we stated earlier on, it's Monday night, August 29th, the summer event of 1988, SummerSlam indeed. And next week, Brain,
yes,
15th, we will have our special 3-hour.
That's right. And I may have a special
guest. May have a surprise for you.
I don't like surprises, you know.
Well,
that.
That's too bad, isn't
Every
it?
Time you give me a surprise, it hurts me.
Well, it's purely intentional.
I know that.
Guarantee you. We're going to be taking a look this week at the guy with the 2x4, Hacksaw Jim Duggan. This latest found friend of yours, Terry Taylor.
I like Terry Taylor.
You're trying to get him into the Heenan family. I know you are.
I didn't
are.
Say that.
Well, I said that. Did you hear
what
me?
What are you, Karnak?
The Hitman is going to be with us, taking on Dangerous Dan.
That's right.
Davis, that is.
I know.
Okay. Who else is going to be
the
here?
The Rockers are going to be here.
Junkyard Dog.
Fabulous Rougeos.
Well, that's our feature. The tag team is our feature. The Rockers. These guys are sensational. Tag team experts.
Yeah, they're that's sensational.
That's what you called them.
Well, that's what they call themselves. I'm just repeating what I heard. Being a journalist, I just tell them, I tell like it's supposed to be told.
I think that the Rougeos are finally showing their true colors. We'll find that out later in the program. Right now, let's take you to the Hitman as he takes on Dangerous Danny Davis.
Well, here we are, 8-8-88, hosted by Gorilla Monsoon, Bobby Heenan, the August 8th edition of Primetime. And you heard it there in the intro. 3 weeks and counting. Had the Mega Powers made a mistake? Well, Bobby Heenan sure thinks so. And next week, it's going to be another 3-hour edition of Primetime upcoming, as the last special, Bobby Heenan had the surprise guest for Gorilla in the form of Brother Love. Well, Monsoon here teasing maybe a surprise for the Brain this time around. Now, later in the show, he's going to announce it'll be Jesse the Body Ventura making a special appearance here on Primetime next week. But spoiler alert, it's only halfway going to happen. We'll have to wait and see if the body has indeed been bought off. But Bobby Heenan vowing to counter Jesse Ventura's appearance by reintroducing Brother Love to the primetime set. Can't wait for that. As a shout out to the gorilla for the Karnak reference as well there. As the show progresses, we go back to Maple Leaf Gardens, July 24th. Terry Taylor scoring a win over Scott Casey with the Scorpion Deathlock. Match goes about 12 minutes here on primetime. And we're going to head back into the studio here. Going to hear a little bit more from Gorilla and Bobby in regards to the newcomer, Terry Taylor.
Last week, right here on Primetime Wrestling, we had a chance to see for the first time young Terry Taylor as he teamed up with Sam Houston and then turned the tables, so to speak.
Well, Sam Houston was incompetent. He lost the fall, and Taylor was felt he was embarrassed in his
debut.
Did
you watch the... Were we watching the same?
Yes, against the Conquistadors last week. Yes. And Sam Houston just went out there and made a complete fool of the whole team.
He did. Terry Taylor taking on Scott Casey. Well, the youngster showed me something. Terry Taylor.
Good. Maybe you've learned something.
Well, he surprised me. You got to have a lot of things on the ball to get by Scott Casey.
Well, Scott Casey is no piece of garbage, as you like to say about most of the people I talk about. He's a very tough, competitive man.
Talking about pieces of garbage, how many pieces of garbage you have involved in SummerSlam 88? You got Andre. You got Hercules. Yeah, I'm talking to you.
Are you talking to me?
Yeah, you got Ravishing Rick.
I don't have pieces of garbage. I have talent. Yeah. I have Ravishing Rick Rude.
Who's going to get a rude awakening from the Junkyard Dog?
You think the dog will kiss him?
Please. Please.
You know, rude awakening from the Junkyard Dog. The Fred Sanford of wrestling? Forget it.
How about Herc? What's he up to these days?
He's up to about 275.
He is.
More powerful than ever.
Well,
he's got Jake the Snake.
I understand.
I hope Mrs. Roberts isn't there making eyes at Herc.
It's just unfortunate.
Herc will go home with
it. Have to pay. We'll be back.
So, again, Sam Houston cost Taylor in his debut match against the Conquistadors. Bobby Heenan backing Scary Terry here. And as Bobby Heenan talks about a piece of garbage, speaking of pieces of garbage, how many does Bobby have in the ring at SummerSlam, asks the Gorilla. And what's Hercules been up to? We haven't seen him a whole lot. What's Herc up to, asks Gorilla. Bobby Heenan's response, what's he up to? About 275. And that'll wrap up the first week in August of 88 in the World Wrestling Federation. And right now we're going to take a quick WrestleCopia timeout. And when we return, it's another full week of WWF action.
Hey everybody, Gene Jackson here, inviting you to check out the Retro Wrestling Review, where each week I'm joined by some great co-hosts who help me review classic episodes of USWA Championship Wrestling, and right now we are doing week-by-week reviews of 1993. But we don't just do reviews, sometimes we get a chance to interview some of the people who were there and lived it, plus do watch-alongs. It's a lot of fun, so check out new episodes that drop every Wednesday at WrestleCopia.com. And to find links to everything associated to the podcast, you can go to USWAPodcast.com.
Hey guys, Ray Russell here, curator of the WrestleCopia Podcast Network, inviting you guys to listen to many of the programs here as part of the WrestleCopia brand, including, but not limited to, the Wrestling Memory Grenade, currently covering the 1988 and the WWF project. You can also listen to the Regional Wrestling Podcast, where we talk the territories, whether it's Jamie Ward with Georgia 81, Roman Gomez with the UWF in 1986, or Gene Jackson covering Memphis in 85. Three projects going on right now over there at Regional Wrestling. You can also listen to the Wrestling Stoop with the legend himself, Bob Roop. Bob goes back in time each and every week, covering not just his career, but countless stories and interactions with hundreds of wrestling names spanning his two decades in the business. But that's not all. You can also check out the Puro Wrestling Academy with the professor of Puro Resu, Mr. Dan Ginnity. Dan and I go back in time and cover the history of Japanese professional wrestling in the English language. And you can listen to all of those shows and more, all part of the WrestleCopia Podcast Network, located over at WrestleCopia.com. That's WrestleCopia.com, and anywhere your podcast streaming needs are met, from Apple to Spotify, Pocket Cast, and beyond. And while you're at it, why not subscribe to our social media, guys, for all the latest goings on here at the WrestleCopia Podcast Network. Plus, I'm constantly adding old school video clips and pictures from throughout wrestling history. You can follow us over on X, formerly Twitter, at Wrestling Grenade. That's at R-A-S-S-L-I-N Grenade. Also, follow and like me, Facebook.com/Wrestling Grenade. And why not subscribe to YouTube.com/Wrestling Grenade? And of course, now would be a fantastic time to become a WrestleCopia patron. I'm talking about that $5 all-access tier over at patreon.com/WrestleCopia. That address again, patreon.com/WrestleCopia, where you get so many gifts for just $5, including all of my insanely detailed show notes for every episode of The Grenade Show, Regional Wrestling, and the Monday Warfare podcast. You'll also get early access to a lot of the podcasts here on the WrestleCopia brand, where you can listen days and sometimes as much as a week earlier than the rest of the listeners. We also offer remastered versions of the earliest episodes of The Grenade Show, covering the 1989 NWA project. It includes enhanced sound quality, plus new content and conversation never heard before. But that's still not all, guys. You also get at least a dozen digital downloads for your viewing and reading pleasure each and every month, plus random bonus video drops, and of course, the Patreon-exclusive Watch Along series covering many past WWF and WCW events. And if that's not all, videocasts, also now a part of Patreon. And for those who like all of their podcasts in one nice, neat little pile, the WrestleCopia Patreon also offers a Patreon-exclusive Spotify account. You can actually go over to your Spotify with your WrestleCopia Patreon credentials. Instead of listening or downloading directly from Patreon, you can go over to Spotify, listen to all the latest shows, including all of the early releases. And you get all of that and so much more for just $5. No subscription, cancel anytime. Give it a try for a month, guys. I think you'll like the content that I offer, and every penny of it goes right back here into paying the bills. So if you're looking to support that next up-and-coming podcast brand, please consider making it WrestleCopia. Help me pay some of the bills to keep the WrestleCopia podcast network and all of the great shows here up and running for the months and the years to come.
This is Wrestling Nostalgia, the podcast that dives into wrestling history. Hey, wrestling fans, I'm Dave Dynasty. And if you enjoy podcasts that are knowledgeable and history-driven, then Wrestling Nostalgia is for you. With great guests and fun interviews, there are over 200 episodes in our archives. We chat with several first-time guests and often cover topics not discussed on other podcasts. Look up Wrestling Nostalgia on your favorite podcast platform and visit all of our links at linktree.com/WrestlePod. That is linktr.ee/RASSLEPOD. And remember, wherever you go, whatever you do, be good, be safe, and keep on growing.
All right, guys, welcome back to the Grenade Show. Back on track here. Off to the following week, Superstars, August the 13th. Taped back a month ago, July 13th, coming to the close of those tapings in La Crosse, Wisconsin, at the La Crosse Center. Vince McMahon, Jesse Ventura, always on commentary, at least for a couple more years. As we're off to the ring, well, you don't get this every week, the WWF Champion in action, Undisputed Champion Randy Macho Man Savage, with the lovely Miss Elizabeth, his opponent this week, the Conquistador, numero uno, or is that dos? I think that's dos. The other Conquistador accompanying him to ringside. Savage could be in trouble. Is the Macho Man out? Of course, with the lovely Liz, but the Champion motioning to the back. Who is he motioning to? We see a familiar face peeking through the curtains. And it is the Hulkster. Hulk Hogan going to come out and even the odds. The Mega Powers in full force here at ringside, brother. Well, you truly don't see that every day. Hulk Hogan in person on syndicated TV. Not since the Boris Zukov squash way back in April or maybe May. And even weirder, maybe the first time Hulk enters to someone else's music. Dude, the Hulkster out to the pomp and circumstance of the Macho Man, Randy Savage the champ. As Jesse Ventura on commentary, he's going to use this match, of course, to put himself over as the mega referee. Guaranteeing there will be a winner. There's that word again, pal. Jesse mentioning that all the other referees in the WWF, they can't measure up to the body handling such a matchup at the pay-per-view. Meanwhile, in the ring, the Conquistador, Jose Estrada, attacking the champion, but he's going to take a backdrop for his trouble. The Masked Man going to try some illegal chicanery, but to no avail as the champion landing a high knee to the back, sending the Masked Man to the floor, and then double axe handle off the top rope to the outside, before rolling Conquistador back in the ring for the patented flying elbow. Going to score the win here, quick and easy for the Macho Man. Match goes 2 minutes and 3 seconds. As then Conquistador Luis Rivera trying to attack Savage, but gets bumped to the floor by the Hulkster, and this one is over. Mega powers must pose, pal, even Miss Elizabeth getting into the act, cupping her ear. Fans eating it up, getting to see the Hulkster and Randy Savage here on TV this week, as we go off now to Update with Mean Gene Okerlund, who has more on SummerSlam.
Pages of the World Wrestling Federation magazine, here's Update.
All right, hi, everybody. This is Mean Gene Okerlund reminding you we're just a shade over 2 weeks away from the big one, SummerSlam 88, on Monday night, August the 29th, from Madison Square Garden in New York City. And what a night of World Wrestling Federation action. I can guarantee you that you can join us by picking up the telephone right now and contacting your cable system and join us on a pay-per-view basis in the comfort of your own home. The Mega Powers to meet the Mega Bucks in the big main event in SummerSlam 88. Undisputed World Wrestling Federation champion Macho Man Randy Savage teaming up with a man who is one of a kind, Hulk Hogan. They're going to be facing Mega Bucks Million Dollar Man Ted DiBiase and his partner, the eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant. Mega ref Jesse the Body Ventura. Personally, I question that decision on the part of World Wrestling Federation President Jack Tunney, handpicking, appointing Jesse Ventura to maintain law and order in this main event when the Mega Powers meet the Mega Bucks. Hey, there's more. The World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, Demolition, Axe, and Smash, to defend against the Hart Foundation, Bret the Hitman Hart, and Jim the Anvil Neidhart. The Harts have smelled the roses before. Of course, they are former Tag Team Champions. What about this title defense for the Intercontinental title holder? Yes, the Honky Tonk Man to defend against Brutus the Barber Beefcake, these who have met before. This will be the last meeting. But privately, Brutus the Barber Beefcake has told me he's going to do one of two things. He is going to capture the Intercontinental crown from the Honky Tonk Man, or he may give him a haircut, or maybe both. By the way, Beefcake is on the front cover of the September issue of the World Wrestling Federation magazine on newsstands right now. By the way, the barber, Brutus Beefcake, does my hair, and I must say I'm very thrilled at the work he does. Great job, right, folks?
Beautiful, Gino.
That's what I thought you'd say. Hey, there's more. Favorites of my dentist, the Powers of Pain, are going to be going against the Bolsheviks. Jake the Snake Roberts to meet the mighty Hercules. In tag team action, the British Bulldogs will face the fabulous Rougeaus. Coco Beware to meet the former prison guard, the Big Boss Man. Ken Patera in this Olympic year to meet Bad News Brown. The Rock, Don Muraco, to meet Canadian strongman Dino Bravo. And I'll tell you what, Junkyard Dog has got his work cut out for him in ravishing Rick Rude in a one-on-one matchup. Plus, there will be a special guest of Brother Love. Yes, Brother Love. Oh, we love you. I love you. Sometimes I wonder if this guy, Brother Love, doesn't work without a net. But then who really cares? He will have a special guest as part of SummerSlam 88 from Madison Square Garden, Monday night, August the 29th. And by the way, please, get a gang together. Get a group together. Enjoy the fun of this tremendous summertime extravaganza. Order it right now on a pay-per-view basis so you can enjoy, as they say, in the comfort of your own home. That's Monday night, the 29th of August, SummerSlam 88, and it's all from the World Wrestling Federation. One tremendous, tremendous event you will not want to miss. For Update, I'm Gene Okerlund.
Mean Gene talking about that upcoming card, 10 matches, Brother Love Show. It's stacked, guys. Maybe not the matches I would have booked, but we'll just have to wait and see how it plays out, especially leading in. As right now, we go off to the ring for Ravishing Rick Rude with Bobby Heenan by his side, taking on Rock and Roll Fuck Zumhoff. You heard me right. It is Buck Zumhoff. Less said about him, the better. As another Rick Rude squash featuring Cheryl Roberts' face on his chunk. And Jesse, I love it. Meanwhile, Vince McMahon appalled. Eh, that's ridiculous, pal. We even get an insert promo here once again from the Ravishing One, who reminds us to check out his tights, as if we could forget. And we get another butt flex pose here on camera, which kind of makes Cheryl look like she's laughing on his ass. Hey, I call it like I see it here. Rude Awakening for another short squash. Going to give Rick Rude the win, 1 minute and 32 seconds. Good, get that piece of shit Zumhoff off my screen. The sooner the better. It's hit or miss with some of the ladies out here, but Rick Rude plants a kiss on another 80s babe this week. She even plays a little hard to get. They eat it up here. They even use it in the slow motion replay. rather than the match. We see Rick Rude tell the lady to come here, motion with his finger, but instead, she actually motions back. No, no, Rick, you come here. Eventually, they meet in the middle, and Rick Rude gonna lay another kiss on another lovely lady here. God bless the 1980s. As we roll off now to the Event Center, and Sean Mooney gonna hear from both sides of the upcoming IC title match at SummerSlam. First, the champion Honky Tonk Man, followed by the Barber.
Hey everyone, I'm Sean Mooney here at the WWF Event Center. We are drawing closer and closer to SummerSlam 88. It happens Monday night, August 29th from New York's Madison Square Garden. One of two title matches to take place for the Intercontinental Championship, the Honky Tonk Man in a final confrontation with Brutus the Barber Beefcake.
You know, Beefcake, after the Honky Tonk Man shake, rattles, and rolls you, we might just get that little bag and cut his hair, huh, Honky?
You know, they're saying SummerSlam 88, August the 29th, Madison Square Garden. Honky Tonk Man, are you a little bit nervous? Are you a little bit disturbed? This is the final meeting for you and Brutus the Barber Beefcake. Well, I am a little bit nervous. I am a little bit disturbed. I'm disturbed because I know that Brutus the Barber does stand a chance of maybe getting the scissors and putting them on my ducktail. I know that he does stand a chance of maybe putting his arms around my neck and squeezing me. I know that he can put me to sleep. He did it in WrestleMania 4. But Brutus the Barber, in order for you to get this belt from me, you've got to beat the Honky Tonk Man. Something you cannot do. You've never been able to do it. And August 29th, you're not going to do it.
What better place could we pick than Madison Square Gardens for the SummerSlam, the final meeting? The final time that you've got to look me in the eye. That you gotta lay down at night. And you gotta remember when I had the sleeper hole around your puny neck and the lights went out on you in WrestleMania. You gotta remember that. Because this time, that's exactly what you're facing, man. I will settle for nothing less than to put the sleeper hole on you, to put you to sleep, and then to take something even more valuable than your title. That's to take your hair, Honky Tonk Man. The duels to do it with, baby. I'm gonna take it. You.
The Barber has everything to gain and nothing to lose in meeting the Honky Tonk Man at SummerSlam 88.
Well, Honky Tonk, he knows there's a chance he can be put to sleep and a chance that he could have his hair cut. But to win the title, Beefcake has to beat Honky Tonk Man, and that's something he's never done. Meanwhile, we hear from the Barber, who continues to remind Honky that he put him out, put him to sleep at WrestleMania 4. He did it once, and he will do it again. This time, the title once again on the line. This time, the Barber vowing to capture the gold. Or maybe the locks of the Honky Tonk Man. Either way, this is billed as Beefcake's final chance. As we go back to the ring tag team action, going to see the British Bulldogs, Davey Boy Smith, Dynamite Kid, with Matilda in their corner. Their opponents this week, Tom Burton and Chris Curtis. As we get an insert promo from the fabulous Rougeau brothers, who have, in my estimation, not so coincidentally been undefeated for the past 90 days, they say, and they'll continue that winning streak at SummerSlam for all of their American fans. USA, say the Rougeau brothers. As the action gets going here, Davey Boy Smith with a crisscross spot in Curtis. Smith going to get the better of that outcome, and then Dynamite in, taking over the Bulldogs in full control. Dynamite going to finish the match, climbing all the way to the top rope for a superplex on Tom Burton, and Kid pops up to make the cover. Dynamite looking sharp as the Bulldogs get the win, 2 minutes and 15 seconds. More action in the ring. Going to see Bad News Brown take on Tim Yates. Is Brown going to attack and work over Yates? We get a Ken Patera insert promo who says Bad News will be Summer Slammed or some shit like that. Ken Patera coming for Bad News Brown at the pay-per-view. The only thing of note in the Bad News Patera feud is that both men were indeed former Olympians. However, the WWF never sold Brown as such, so it's just another match. As we go off now to the Event Center, Sean Mooney standing by with a Megabucks promo.
This may be perhaps the greatest tag team confrontation ever to take place. It will happen at SummerSlam 88, Monday night, August 29th, from New York's Madison Square Garden. The Mega Powers versus the Mega Bucks. The Mega Powers, Hulk Hogan and the Macho Man, Randy Savage. They will face the Mega Bucks, Andre the Giant and the Million Dollar Man.
So the cat's out of the bag, Savage. The cat's out of the bag. The big announcement's been made. Hulk Hogan's gonna come back one more time. One more time you're gonna go to the well, Hogan.
one more time you're going to get in the ring and face this man. You've been licking your wounds for a few months now. You've been hiding under a rock. And you're coming back because you think you got a safe face. You're coming back. You said it yourself, Hogan. All your little hulksters are starting to fall off the track, left and right. They're going in there asking for their allowance before the job's been done. They're getting in fights at school. Why? Why? Because they're starting to come around to the fact that what the million-dollar man has said all along is the truth. Money is the power. Money buys everything. Money, mega bucks, is what it's all about. They're finding that out, Hogan, and you're coming back in desperation. Coming back desperately, desperately trying to hold it together. But it ain't gonna happen. Tell him, Andre.
Oh, it's not gonna happen because I'm going to win again.
And I'll tell you something. Everybody's talking about Elizabeth. Great manager. The only thing she managed to do is buy some lousy-looking discount gaudy dresses. You want to manage something? You go work at the diner and hustle hash. That's all you're going to be good for. This is the mega power. This is the mega bucks and the mega brain.
They're talking about the kiss of life and the kiss of death. You want to kiss something?
You kiss,
this right here.
Last week on Superstars, it was the mega powers, this time the mega bucks getting their fair share of time. Then back to the ring for Hacksaw Jim Duggan taking on George Petraski. And if only Duggan knew his opponent here would soon portray a communist Russian. Flashbacks of the old Bill Watts UWF promotion here. Duggan all over Petraski. Now George going to find a few shoulder butts on Hacksaw in the corner, but he turns around and makes the mistake of mocking Hacksaw. George Petraski giving the fans the big thumbs up and a big ho. And a big mistake is what it is. Huge right hand. Petraski turns around to the ham hock of one Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Great response from the fans as well from that entire spot. Followed by the three-point stance and clothesline. Going to give Duggan the 1-2-3. Match goes 1 minute and 12 seconds. Duggan just flying through that clothesline anymore. Blasting through Petraski, scoring the quick victory for Hacksaw this week. As we go off now to a special interview. Craig DeGeorge standing by with the tag team champions Demolition, their manager Mr. Fuji, and Jimmy Hart.
It is the pay-per-view spectacular of the summer, and it is coming your way, direct from Madison Square Garden in New York City on Monday, August the 29th. It is SummerSlam 88, available on pay-per-view systems nationwide. Now, among the featured matches, back together perhaps better than ever, the former World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, the Hart Foundation, and Jim the Anvil Neidhart and Bret the Hitman Hart will take on my guests at this time, led by their manager, Mr. Fuji. They are the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, Axe and Smash Demolition.
Awesome duo there with Axe and Smash. What's Jimmy Hart? What's he doing up there?
I don't know, but I think the Hart Foundation just made a major mistake.
Demolition, Jimmy Hart, what in the world are you doing out here? You, of course, have a vested interest in the opponents of Demolition in the SummerSlam. Why are you out here?
I am the man who took the Hart Foundation to the top of the World Wrestling Federation. I did it with my brains, and I did it with my ability. And what kind of things did Jimmy Hart get? I'll tell you what kind of things. When I went out to ringside with them, they chased me back to the dressing room. And when I went back to the dressing room, there was a big sign on the door that said, Jimmy Hart, keep out. They have laughed at me, and they have humiliated me. And nobody makes a fool out of Jimmy Hart. So what did I do? I got a hold of my good friend, Mr. Fuji. And I said, Mr. Fuji, let's form an alliance. Because you see, in SummerSlam 88, the Demolition take on the Hart Foundation for the World Wrestling Federation tag team titles. And I said, Mr. Fuji, who knows more about the Hart Foundation than Jimmy Hart?
Exactly.
I know their strong points, and I know their weaknesses. And believe you me, Mr. Fuji, they have a lot of weaknesses. I'll assure you of that. I will squeal like a canary. Oh. I will spill my guts out to you.
I can't believe
because
it.
You see, Foundation,
why?
I'll make sure that you'll never become the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions again.
All I right, told you the Hearts made a major mistake, McMahon, and there it is.
What about it, Smash?
You Jimmy said Hart. They didn't need Jimmy
you
Hart.
You send the messages to Master Fuji, and Master Fuji will send them to us.
Hart Foundation, the reason why we're here is because we are champions. We've beat up every opponent and bad. So when it comes to Madison Square Gardens, Master Fuji has told us when you step through the ropes to kick your teeth in and that right ass.
That's right. The Hart Foundation is like all the other bums and lowlifes we wrestle. No better. Jimmy Hart's gonna get a present. Right here, we're the champions. We're gonna make a promise to you. We're gonna send both those bums to the hospital. Jimmy, that's a promise.
World Tag Team Champions now, and World Tag Team Champions after SummerSlam 88!
All right, Demolition, the Hart Foundation, SummerSlam 88.
Turning against the Hart Foundation.
You can't believe it after what they did to him. He has every right to.
And why, oh why, is Jimmy Hart out here for the interview? Jimmy telling everybody that he was the man who brought the Hart Foundation the titles in the first place. Hart's only champions due to Jimmy Hart's managerial skills. Well, Jimmy did play a big part in that, I won't lie. But Jimmy says he knows all the strengths of the Hart Foundation and more so, their many weaknesses. Jimmy vowing that he will reveal them all to Mr. Fuji to make sure the Hart Foundation never regained the tag team gold. Now that's just plain evil, man. The Demolition then vowing to demolish and destroy the Harts at SummerSlam. So, the storyline, it makes sense on paper. Jimmy Hart, the Jimmy Hart factor. Great way to keep that going, but the feud between Jimmy Hart and his former tag team. I just wish the focus was more on Axe and Smash here, but I get what they're doing. As we continue on, we see the Rockers. Apparently they love to eat. Now guys, get your mind out of the gutter. I'm talking about WWF ice cream bars. Even the Rockers say, hey, on a hot summer night, there's only one way to cool off. And it's not what you think. It is the WWF ice cream bars. Fun little promo there from Shawn Michaels, Marty Jannetty. Back to the ring for Dino Bravo in action. Frenchie Martin by his side. Dino's opponent this week, Chris Czarnoff. And we get an insert promo here from Rock Don Muraco talking SummerSlam. Talking about both of his foes right now, Dino Bravo and Greg Valentine. Boy, Muraco in two feuds, if you will, or at least matches, whatever you want to call it, and they pick maybe the two least over heels right now in the entire company. I suppose they figure if he works with both guys, that should equal one good heel, right? I don't know. Anyway, in the ring, Dino Bravo with a folding back suplex and the side suplex going to get the win here for Dino. Match goes a quick 1 minute, 16 seconds. Which leaves time for one more match here this week on Superstars. Powers of Pain taking on Rick Gantner and Frankie DeFalco. And the job guy is going to try to attack the POP, but to no avail. The babyface monsters whipping the job guys into one another and a pair of clotheslines taking Gantner and DeFalco down. We also get an insert promo here from the Bolsheviks and Slick, who say the Powers of Pain are ashamed of their past, and that's why they hail from parts unknown. I wrote LOL. Slick always could cut a fun promo here. Jesse believes that Parts Unknown is actually located in Wyoming. Funny. I always thought it was in one of the Dakotas myself. Anywho, back to the ring. Barbarian going to land his big boot, followed by the Warlord Power Slam. Barbarian diving headbutt, taking DeFalco down. Going to give the Powers the Pain the win. 3 minutes and 2 seconds. As we close out this week's Superstars, back to the Event Center, Sean Mooney. And yet again, we hear from the Mega Powers.
We are back at the World Wrestling Federation Event Center. And right now, as promised, talking about this great tag team confrontation against the Mega Bucks are the Mega Powers, the Macho Man, Randy Savage, and Hulk Hogan.
Thank God, Macho Brother. I got the Mega Power Psycon going in the 11th hour of this thing. Yes, it makes me realize just how large the task is we have to complete. The fact that some of our little maniacs are starting to push each other around on the playground makes me realize they're already starting to derail. Also, the fact that they're asking for their allowance before they get their chores done worries me a little bit. That just tells me and you what we have to do about the situation.
Yeah, but at the SummerSlam in Madison Square Gardens, I want you to do me a favor.
What is it?
I want you to do me a favor. I want you to set up the $1 million man.
Oh, yeah.
So I can slam him in the middle of the ring and go to the top rope and jump off and crush him with my big elbow. Yeah, his ribs. And then I want Elizabeth to distract the eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant.
Yeah.
And then you sneak up behind him and press him over your head like you've done before. And the big man takes him and smashes him to the mat. And then I go to the top rope, drop that big elbow, and smash your ribs.
Yeah.
Well, you know, one good turn deserves another. If I do that for you, you gotta let me cinch both of them up in a Hulkster bear hug, man. Make the snap, crackle, and pop come from the giant and the multi-million-dollar man. But Don't. Just to turn you guys on right before they go down, just as you're getting Jesse Ventura on our face, I'll let them get a gasp of air. I'll let them look across the apron. I'll give them one last look at Madison Square Garden before our lovely manager looks at them and gives them the mega power kiss of death.
Hulk Hogan fearing about his Hulkamaniacs. Getting fronted their allowance money. God, I don't know what they're going to do. Buy the SummerSlam pay-per-view? I don't know. But Hogan fearing that his Hulkamaniacs beginning to turn on one another, beginning to maybe do some wrong for fear they won't finish their chores if they get their money in advance. Not really sure where he was going with all of that. But the Mega Powers stating what they'd love to do at SummerSlam is basically hit their moves, the flying elbow, Hulkster with the body slam leg drop, and Elizabeth apparently with the Mega Power kiss of death. Elizabeth kissing the camera, a little out of character for Miss Liz, but a fun little promo there. Overall, Mega Powers, Mega Bucks, you know the drill. We go on to Wrestling Challenge, August the 14th, finishing out the tapings in Cedar Rapids, Iowa. Five Seasons Center, taped all the way back a month ago, July 14th. It's Bobby Heenan, Gorilla Monsoon on commentary here. Off to the ring for the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, accompanied by Virgil and Andre the Giant. This week, DiBiase taking on JT Thomas. Meanwhile, Bobby Heenan going to remain on commentary. He's not needed out there. Heenan using commentary, of course, here to trash the Mega Powers while the cocky DiBiase takes control. Thomas eventually going to sneak in an inside cradle and an arm drag, which, again, only upsets the Million Dollar Man as the fans start up a weird chant of, Andre is a bum! Andre is a bum! Ted DiBiase with that Million Dollar fist drop, followed by the Million Dollar Dream, going to get the win 2 minutes. In 42 seconds, JT Thomas eating a $100 bill for good measure after the matchup. As we go off to a special report this week, Craig DeGeorge again running down the SummerSlam card and then back to the ring for Jake the Snake Roberts. His opponent this week, Tom Stone. And we get a weird spot early on where it looked like Jake dropkicked Stone in the shin. And I'm not really sure what that was supposed to be, but I don't think it was that. Meanwhile, Jake going to dominate, but running into a knee in the corner from Stone. Tom going to try to capitalize with a body slam, but Jake simply floats over into the DDT out of nowhere, scoring the win for the Snake Man 2 minutes and 34 seconds. And post-match, Damian out to play once again. Now, during this matchup, Gorilla Monsoon did accuse Bobby Heenan of booking Hercules in a match versus Jake at SummerSlam as a way to prevent Roberts from wrestling Rick Rude. Maybe Hercules could even accidentally injure, the Snake Gorilla hypothesizes. Now, I'm not sure if this was strategic storytelling or if Gorilla and Bobby were simply making sense of this shit booking for the pay-per-view, but either way, I do give some kudos for them trying to salvage the story here. Basically, Rude running and hiding for the Snake Man, and so Bobby Heenan using Hercules as a pawn in all of this, putting him in front of Rick to take on Jake at the pay-per-view. We deserve the money match, ravishing Rick and Jake the Snake, at least in my opinion. But that's simply not meant to be, at least not at SummerSlam as we go off now to the Event Center. We heard this recently on the Grenade, but a really fun promo from both sides. We go off now to Sean Mooney, upcoming match at SummerSlam. We're going to hear from the British Bulldogs and the Fabulous Rougeaus. This is not deja vu for anyone who remembers it. We did hear this promo before. Davey talking about the famous Fabulous Flying Rougeaus. And of course, both sides mocking the other's accents. Should be a fun match when we get to the pay-per-view. Back to the ring, tag team of the Bolsheviks with Slick in their corner, taking on Chris Zarna and Frank DeFalco. We get an insert promo here from the Powers of Pain, who state they will show the Russians who is the most powerful and who is the most painful at the pay-per-view. We get the old Russian national anthem to start, and the Bolsheviks got a control here. Zarna trying for a dropkick, but misses on Zhukov. Nikolai M with the old gorilla press into the backbreaker spot. Volkov then with an over-the-shoulder backbreaker. Zhukov again off the middle rope. Forearm into the chest of Zarna. Going to give the Bolsheviks the win. 2 minutes and 13 seconds. So the match between the Russians and the Powers of Pain at the pay-per-view is such a foregone conclusion that even Bobby Heenan picks the Powers of Pain to win. Think about that. But the action rolls on here. Wrestling challenge, Tito Santana taking on Rick Gantner. And it was arm locks last week by Tito, so this week it's headlocks from Santana. Hey, at least he's changing it up, guys. Gantner with some brief offense in between, but it's the flying forearm. Arriba! Gonna get the win every time for Santana. Match goes 2 minutes and 30 seconds. Tito just kind of floundering around at this point. We roll off now to the event center, Sean Mooney. We get the Mega Power Kiss of Death promo once again here on Wrestling Challenge. And then we see Hacksaw Duggan enjoying himself an ice cream bar here in the hot August sun of 1988. Even Hacksaw Duggan enjoying himself a little dairy. Tough guy. Then back to the ring for Greg the Hammer Valentine, manager Jimmy Hart, Valentine's opponent Warren Bianchi. We get an insert promo from Don Muraco, who talks SummerSlam and Dino Bravo during a Valentine match. Okay. We see a back suplex here from the Hammer, followed by a double underhook suplex, and the shin guard assisted figure four going to score the immediate victory. Match goes 1 minute and 39 seconds. Greg Valentine, he's there. Not part of the pay-per-view, but he's there. As we roll off now to the Brother Love Show, his guest this week is the one and only, the manager, Jimmy Hart. Jimmy Hart here talking all about the upcoming match, not between Honky and Beefcake, but instead he's out here to talk about Demolition taking on his former team, the Hart Foundation.
This week, I would like to have as my guest a gentleman whose very name oozes love. So please welcome now my dear friend, Brother Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart.
Oh. Now we got two bleeding hearts out there.
Brother Miles, it is indeed a pleasure to have you here. But I understand that there is some dissension within the ranks of the Hart Foundation.
You know, Brother Love, my heart is heavy because of the Hart Foundation. They have turned their back on the light that guided them to the top of the World Wrestling Federation.
Hallelujah.
But I don't get mad, Brother Love, but I will get even.
Now, Brother Mal,
heart's heavy, but his wallet's light.
The Hart Foundation will battle the team, the World Tag Team Champions, Demolition, at SummerSlam 88. Is that correct?
That is right, Brother Love. And I've got a big, big surprise, Brother Love. Because you see, Mr. Fuji and Jimmy Hart have joined forces.
Uh-oh.
And at SummerSlam 88, I will be standing next to them in their corner when they take on the Hart Foundation
are better than one,
for the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team titles.
Boy, that's a shocker.
Well, so you will essentially be right there in the corner to back Demolition?
I'll be standing right there, and I'm going to tell everything I know about the Hart Foundation. I'm going to tell all of their secrets, all of their weaknesses.
A heart?
Everything. Oh, look,
out there.
Here they are, Brother Love. Look at Jim the Animal Nightheart. I took these guys.
Pick on a guy like Jimmy Hart.
Look at him. Jimmy, when I managed you, baby, you were in shape. Look at that big belly sliding over his tights. Look at you, Bret Hart. Just because a couple of fat, pimp women and girls screamed over you, you thought you were Robert Wrestling.
There he goes.
Now,
he's done his true colors.
Just a moment. Now, Brother Anvil, Brother Hitman, now here was a man who loved you. His love took you to the pinnacle, took you to the top. Federation.
We got rid of Jimmy Hart because he loved.
That's right. He loved you. He loved you too.
Our money.
Oh.
He loved.
Now the truth's coming out.
Our glory. And most of all, he loved himself.
knocked out. And he's nothing but a false prophet just like you.
You got him pegged, Hitman.
Let me tell you something else. We are going to love, on August 29th, we are going to love to win back the World Heavyweight Tag Team Championship of the world. Get it, baby!
Look at Brother Love. He didn't have anything to say.
You know, I think a very important part here was missed. He's a Jimmy Hart loved glory. He loved the money. He loved the fame. He gave them love,
please.
Money, fame, and glory.
Please.
So Brother Love opening the show there, promoting his appearance at SummerSlam with a very special guest. Okay. Then out comes a man whose name apparently oozes love in Jimmy Hart. I get it. Love, Hart. Okay. Jimmy Hart promising revenge on the Hart Foundation, and it all starts at SummerSlam when he gives Mr. Fuji and Demolition all the info they need to defeat Bret Hart and Jim Neidhart. Jimmy Hart announces that he will be working as kind of a secondary manager of sorts to tag team champions Demolition for the pay-per-view. And all of that going to bring out the former tag champs, the Hitman and the Anvil out here, confronting Jimmy Hart. Now Jimmy laying in some choice words before scurrying away as the Hart Foundation state that all Jimmy ever loved about the team was the money he was stealing from them, as well as the glory he took. Bret Hart says Jimmy was a false prophet, much like Brother Love, and on August the 29th, the Hart Foundation are gonna love winning back the tag team titles. Gotta love all the love puns here. Hart Foundation looking to win back championship gold in just a few weeks' time. As we go back to the ring, we saw him last week here on Superstars. This week, Terry Taylor on Wrestling Challenge. His opponent, Cowboy Scott Casey. As we get an insert promo here again from Scary Terry. Now, last week, we heard Taylor, he mentioned his handsomely good looks. And this time, he takes it a step further, saying the divorce rate will rise with the arrival of, get ready for it, the Mecca of manhood. The Mecca of manhood, Terry Taylor. As he gets cocky here early on against Scott Casey, and the Cowboy got to let him have it. Scott Casey taking over, landing a crucifix, getting a two count out of that. Terry, though, comes right back with a hot shot, working over Casey. Scotty going to try to fire up for his bulldog, but Taylor shoves him into the far corner and lands a spine buster on the rebound, followed by the Scorpion Deathlock. Going to get the submission win for Terry. Match goes 3 minutes and 2 seconds. So now, after last week and this week, I'm not sure if Terry Taylor is Scary Terry or the Mecca of manhood. And how those two tie into each other, I have no idea. But clearly, a poor man's Rick Rude gimmick at this point, not going to fly in the same promotion as Rick, and soon managed by the same manager. Bobby Heenan on commentary here, continuing to push his interest in Terry Taylor, even referring to him as cocky, if you know what I mean. Back to the ring, more action. Going to see the Big Boss Man with manager Slick in his corner taking on Tom Dixon. As we get an insert promo here from Slick and the Boss Man running down the Big Boss Man's opponent at SummerSlam, talking about Coco Beware. Gorilla Monsoon bringing up the potential of a Boss Man one-man gang tag team. Both men right now managed by Slick, of course. Makes sense. Got a cop and a street thug. They go together. Now Gorilla going to get his wish of a tag team between those two men, but one-man gang, maybe not. As Tom Dixon makes a lunge at the Boss Man, runs and jumps into his arms. Can't say that I blame him. Trying to get a running start, but doesn't work here. Boss Man countering it into a spine buster. First move of the matchup, followed by a big boot. And eventually, it's a reverse shoulder breaker. Papa Shango style. Man, that was nasty. Going to give the Big Boss Man the win. 1 minute and 26 seconds in post-match. Boss Man, of course, handcuffing Dixon to the ropes, beating him down with the nightstick for another fun squash here by the Big Boss Man. Very intimidating character, no doubt. Just rough in there. And this is during that period in July. This was taped in July, remember. Boss Man using that reverse shoulder breaker in a couple of TV matches, as well as his matches with Sam Houston on the house shows. At least one of those aired. So he was trying something different out from the Bubba Spike. But thank God we go back to the Boss Man slam before too long. In fact, likely by the next time we see him here on TV. As we close things out, another Event Center, Sean Mooney. We're going to hear from the IC champion, Honky Tonk Man, Brutus Beefcake.
Two individuals who have battled each other tooth and nail will have their final meeting at SummerSlam 88 on Monday night, August 29th. And I am referring to the Honky Tonk Man and Brutus the Barber Beefcake. Honky Tonk's Intercontinental Championship will be on the line. And right now, both champion and challenger are standing by with comments on this tumultuous clash.
You know, Beefcake, I know you want the Honky Tonk Man's Intercontinental Championship belt. And I know you want his hair, baby, but you'll never get it.
They say Honky Tonk Man, you're all swelled up there. You look real good now. You're full of confidence. Because all of my fans, all of my friends, everywhere around the world, when they found out I would never have to wrestle Brutus at Barber Beefcake again, they gave me the confidence I need to go into this match, SummerSlam 88, August the 29th, Madison Square Garden. They gave me the confidence I need to shake, rattle, and roll you, to not be afraid, because I know, Brutus, I know that you can't put me to sleep, I know you can't take my belt, and I know deep down inside you will never cut my hair.
Well, I cannot wait, Mr. Honky Tonk Man, for the final meeting. Yes, the final meeting between you and I. You say, I can't beat you. You say, I can't take your title. Well, I say there's a lot that can happen when you take cold steel into the ring with you. And I think you've got a short memory, because the sleeper hold did a go around your neck, did put you out right in the center of the ring. You are sleeping in WrestleMania. Did you forget already? Well, don't forget these, because these are coming after you. And they're gonna get you, believe me.
The Barber has everything to gain and nothing to lose in meeting the Honky Tonk Man at SummerSlam 88.
Final showdown at SummerSlam. Brutai talking about his cold steel, of course the hedge clippers, looking to take off Honky's ducktail, and if Honky ain't careful, his hind tail as well. Beefcake coming for the gold and Honky's hair. As we close out this week's wrestling challenge, we learn that next week's guest on the Brother Love Show is none other than the mega ref himself, Jesse the Body Ventura, live and in living color on the Brother Love Show here next week. Maybe we'll get to the bottom of it. Has the body been bought off by the Million Dollar Man and crew? We won't have to wait long to find out. As we close out this grenade, we got one last piece of business. The 3-hour special edition of Primetime Wrestling, airing August the 15th, hosted by Bobby Heenan and Gorilla Monsoon. As this is a super shill for SummerSlam, local closed circuit TV availability listed state by state between every commercial break, breaking it down a couple states between every commercial break here for 3 hours straight, making sure that everyone knows where to go to watch the big pay-per-view. As we go off now, remember the guest that was promised last week, Jesse Ventura? Well, no, not the body. I'm talking about Bobby Heenan's guest. The brain welcoming back Brother Love himself. Can't wait to see how Gorilla responds.
I have a guest that you're going to enjoy.
Unannounced guest?
I'm the host. I can do what I want. People are going to enjoy it. You're going to enjoy it.
A guest of yours, the people are going to enjoy.
That's correct. I don't even have to say his name.
Jesse the Body Ventura. Jesse doesn't have music.
It's not Jesse.
Come on. Not that music. Give me a break, will you, please?
My man, brother. Brother Love, how are you?
Time for me to bail out of here, I think.
Now, wait just a minute, Brother Gorilla, because...
I can't take you.
I get the feeling that you don't like Brother Love.
Something a little queerish about you that I just can't...
Now, just a minute, because...
I got to go to Jiffy
Lube. You said last time that maybe I could stay if I just didn't say those three words.
I said that.
Yes, but I'm not going to do it if you'll stay, and I brought you something. For you, Brother Gorilla.
I got something for you, and you'll get it, I'm sure. So long.
But I love you. He's leaving again, Brother Brain.
It worked.
So Monsoon says he thinks there's something a little queerish about Brother Love, who presents Gorilla with another gift this week, a heart-shaped balloon. But Monsoon has had enough leaving the studio for the next couple segments, allowing Bobby Heenan and Brother Love to host for just a little bit. But eventually, Gorilla back, and, well, they promised us Jesse Ventura in the studio. But he is not here this week. Instead, from the green screen of Hollywood, the Hollywood sign, here's a promo from the body.
You know,
SummerSlam 88 is 2 weeks away. And it's two important weeks for me, Jesse the Body Ventura, because it's been 2.5 years since I've stepped into a ring. Now, I'm stepping into a ring in a little different fashion this time, not the one you're used to. I'm going in as special guest referee for the main event. The Mega Powers, Hulk Hogan and the world champion Randy Macho Man Savage, take on the Mega Bucks, the Million Dollar Man Ted DiBiase, and Andre the Giant. And President Jack Tunney knew there was only one dude in the whole world that could step in there and come out with a clean-cut winner. And that was me. Now, I'm going to tell you people a lot of things that have gone on. People have said there's a jealousy between me and Hulk Hogan. There's not a jealousy. I'm not jealous of Hulk Hogan. He's jealous of me. Because I'm the movie star. I don't wrestle today, you know why? Not because I couldn't. But because with this pretty face, there's no telling how far I'm going. And I ain't risking getting it bust open. So when I referee this match coming up, I'm going to call it down the middle. And the best team will win. And I'll hold up the hand of the best team that wins. But there's a lot of speculation. Can Jesse the Body Ventura be bought by the Million Dollar Man? Because at one time, I said everyone had a price for the Million Dollar Man. But I've made a lot of money of my own now. And I'm not really sure if the Million Dollar Man could buy me off. A lot of people say Jesse the Body Ventura retired because he couldn't hack it in the ring anymore, that people like Andre the Giant scared him. Well, I was never afraid of you, Andre the Giant. You know that, and I know that. And bear one thing in mind. My face, my body's heavily insured now. And Andre the Giant, you can't touch a referee. That's fine and suspension, and I hold all the rights of a referee in that ring. So this match is going to happen, SummerSlam, and the body is going to head down the Madison Square Garden for the first time in 2.5 years. And the body will determine a winner. There will be a winner, the best team. And that, my friend, is what I got to say on SummerSlam 88.
So Jesse Ventura continues to hard sell. This is his first time in a wrestling ring in 2.5 years. The mega referee gonna call it right down the middle, referring to the Hulkster as jealous of the body. I think he still does that today. Ventura mentioning he could wrestle himself, but he can't risk the chances of getting his pretty face busted up while filming movies in Hollywood. Ventura goes on to state that he's made his own money now, thanks to the movies. He's not so sure that he can be bought off by the Million Dollar Man. Now, that question will linger leading into the pay-per-view. More on that on the next grenade, though, guys. But finishing out this primetime wrestling show, 3 hours? You better believe there are some exclusives. No less than 5 exclusives, to be exact. Starting off June 21st, Glens Falls, New York. Don Muraco over Iron Mike Sharp with the Tombstone. Very impressive every time Muraco picking Sharp up near 300-pounder into that Tombstone. Going to give Muraco the win, 3 minutes and 50 seconds. Also, a couple of matches taped August 3rd in Wheeling, West Virginia at the Civic Center. Going to see Jake the Snake Roberts pinning Dangerous Danny Davis. Match goes 8 minutes, 17 seconds. Snake Man going to slap on the DDT and then shove Damian down the trunks, down the tights of one Dangerous Danny. I should point out, Jimmy Hart still the manager of Danny Davis at this point in time. Also from Wheeling, West Virginia, great matchup for TV. Million Dollar Man Ted DiBiase accompanied to the ring by Virgil and Andre. DiBiase scoring a TV win over Jumping Jim Brunzel. Matchup goes near 9.5 minutes. DiBiase landing an elbow drop after Brunzel missing a dropkick. Brunzy sending DiBiase into the ropes looking for that dropkick finisher, but Andre grabbing hold of DiBiase, pulling him back, causing Brunzel to miss. DiBiase able to capitalize and steal the win. Again, really fun match. Go check it out. Also, a couple matches taped in Dayton, Ohio at the old Hera Arena. Been there a time or two. These were taped August the 2nd. Going to see the Junkyard Dog battle the One Man Gang. Haven't seen him a lot on TV lately. It's the dog and the gang going to a double countout. 6 minutes and 39 seconds also here on primetime this week. Squash match. Ultimate Warrior over Tom Burton with the press drop and the splash, scoring the win 2 minutes, 24 seconds. Closing out this week's primetime wrestling. And closing out this week's edition of the Grenade Show. I want to thank everybody here for tuning in once again as we continue on just 2 weeks away from SummerSlam 88. And just a few words here on SummerSlam. Now, next time we come back, another 2 weeks of TV, going to look at everything going on the final 2 weeks leading into the pay-per-view. And then in two episodes time, we will be back with SummerSlam 88, the definitive edition here on the Grenade. Going to look at each and every match, break the pay-per-view down from beginning to end. But I encourage everybody now to head on over to patreon.com/wrestlecopia. That address again, patreon.com/wrestlecopia. Talking about that VIP superfan tier, guys. And yes, the $5 all-access tier, still available. Lots of great gifts there. But I'm talking right now to you about the VIP superfan tier. Gets you all of the VIP video casts, including our upcoming video cast of SummerSlam 88. You don't want to miss it. Nearly another 3 hours of fun. We had such a great time, me and Gene Jackson, last time around covering WrestleFest 88. I invited Gene back again to cover SummerSlam. And that's going to be coming to you very shortly there at Patreon. Join today as spots are limited. Also want to encourage everybody to head over to WrestleCopia.com for all of the great podcasts, everything going on now at the WrestleCopia brand, from the outdated Wrestling Hour, Bob Smith joining the brand, to Dave Dynasty and the Wrestling Nostalgia podcast. Very timely right now. Dave's guest this week on the show, you're going to hear him interview Barry Darso, Demolition Smash. And of course, the demos heading into SummerSlam as the tag team champions. And next week on the Wrestling Nostalgia podcast, Dave going to interview one Baron Von Raschke. And that's very timely as well, because the Baron about to pop up here as a brand new manager in the World Wrestling Federation. So great interviews right now with Dave Dynasty. Check those out over at the Wrestling Nostalgia podcast. And of course, our very own Gene Jackson co-hosting with Doug Gilbert, Dangerous Conversations this week. Doug Gilbert going to interview his good friend, the Dirty White Boy, Tony Anthony, a.k.a. TL Hopper to you WWF fans. But before that, he was a grappler. And of course, he was the Dirty White Boy, Tony Anthony. Go check that out. All of that and so much more going on right now as part of the WrestleCopia brand. And of course, all those shows available on all of your favorite podcast streaming platforms. And of course, I'd be remiss if I didn't ask everybody to head over to my social media so that you have an idea of what goes on here day to day at the network. But also, I have been adding an insane amount of videos and even some pictures out there on my social media from throughout wrestling history. You'll really enjoy it. If you follow me on X, formerly Twitter, at Wrestling Grenade, that's at R-A-S-S-L-I-N Grenade. And also be sure to follow me at Facebook.com/Wrestling Grenade. Over 21,000 followers right now and counting over there at Facebook. Would love to have you as part of that. And last but certainly not least, not only do you get the video cast version of Gene Jackson's Retro Wrestling Review, the USWA in 1993, over at my YouTube, but also adding all sorts of other videos as time allows. So be sure to subscribe to youtube.com/Wrestling Grenade. And I almost forgot, we're back in business, talking about Dan Ginnity and the Puro Wrestling Academy. Summer vacation is over and the Academy is back in session. Dan Ginnity, we just dropped the 1958 episode covering the history of Japanese professional wrestling last week. This week, it's 1959 as we talk about the first ever World League taking place in Japan wrestling, as well as the Masked Mr. Atomic and so much more. And we are just one episode away from the debut of both Antonio Inoki and the Giant Baba. So head on over to the Puro Wrestling Academy. New episodes going up right now. And with all of that said out of the way, we're going to be back two more weeks of WWF TV here in August of 88, very soon. And then it's off to SummerSlam before we move into the fall. Arn Anderson, Tully Blanchard on the way. The one-man gang going to go through a transformation of sorts. So much to look forward to in the weeks to come. But right now, all roads lead to the pay-per-view, guys. And I encourage you guys to return here next time on The Grenade. Again, a big thank you to Matt Crowder. His support of the brand means so very much, brother. And until next time, this is Ray Russell saying from pillar to post and coast to coast. You pull the pin, and I'll pick up the pieces right here on the Wrestling Memory Grenade. I'll see you next week. Don't miss it. Be there!
Now, wait just a minute, Brother Gorilla, because...
I can't take you.
I get feeling that you don't like Brother Love.
Something a little queerish about you that I just can't...
Just a minute, because I'm not going to do it if you'll stay. And I brought you something for you, Brother Gorilla.
I got something for you, and you'll get it, I'm sure. So long.
But I love you. He's leaving again, Brother Brain.